is my brother Scott. You see him on camera before here. I made him a guitar years ago. I guess it's still holding together. He's still playing it, huh?
Okay.
Well, good. But he's not satisfied because he wants to make another one. But at least he's making it for his son, Joe. And he's got a bunch of components here that we're going to show you real quick. He's already been tinkering, and here's some of his tinkering. Did you ever see such a vine in a fingerboard? So his laser cutter is much bigger than mine. You know, you judge everything by the size of your laser cutter. How big did you say yours is? The one you
did? Is it 12 by 20?
12 by 20. And he says he's got a bigger one that he hasn't even set up yet. It's like 12 by 20 is not big enough. Yeah, it's an obsession.
I have one that'll do the body of a guitar. I got it off Craigslist on the cheap, so I got to do some repairs to it.
Well,
get it fixed up.
Anyway, that looks pretty cool, though. I'll try to give you a close-up there if the light will quit glaring it out.
Oh, it's still rough.
It's still rough. He hasn't filled it and all that yet. And of course, the camera's not focusing, of course. But anyway, I'll give you some idea what he's planning to do. This is some practice inlay he's been doing, which I thought looks pretty good to me for practice. He's thinking about putting that design in a pickguard or something. He's got his tuning keys picked out. They look like they're ebony, Waverly tuning keys. Ebony. Putting my hands up there to block it. And you wonder why I'm wearing gloves? Well, I'm about to show you that. Mr. Sensitive here says that every time he touches this, he gets splinters. And he said, you better wear gloves. I thought, okay. This is what he's planning to make the guitar body out of, the back and the sides. What'd you say it was called again? Leopard wood?
Leopard wood.
Leopard wood. You know, I thought it was lace wood or something. I've seen lots of wood like this.
Those two are confused often. They are two different species.
Yeah. Anyway, he's been doing some test staining and finishing up here in this area. It's very heavy, very dense. You can tell. Just this little board, you'd be surprised what it weighs. It's heavy. And you can, like these little marks on here, you can actually feel some of them a little bit, depending on which way you rub your hand. And but it is kind of splintery, I'm sure. So
the edge is rough sawn too.
Yeah, and the edge is rough sawn. So anyway, I think we're about ready to get started. We're gonna probably start by just chopping this off to length for long enough to do the sides, and then we'll set up our AccuSlice system and slice out the sides and the back from this one piece that we're going to cut out, and I'm pretty sure we can get enough out of this. Looks to be just a hair over 3/4 of an inch thick is what it looks like.
Yeah, like 15, 16.
Yeah, so anyway, I think we can get enough out of just one piece probably to make the whole back and sides, but you'll see. You can come along for the ride.
We'll be right back. think it is on the bottom side and it is on the top side.
That's why you do the extra stick on the wasteboard.
Well, we think it went okay. We're going to analyze it. I'm probably going to go ahead and change the blade. That's basically a new blade, but it's only a 3/8, and really that's more than that blade should do. So I think I'm probably going to go ahead and change the blade out. That's probably my bad for just even trying that little blade. Cut very, very nice, but this just cuts slow as it can cut. The blade is a teeny bit warm, but not even really what you'd almost call warm, just a very lukewarm, so it's not hot or anything. Yeah, there we go. So. getting ready to thicken the sand his sides. One of the sides, we got a little bit of a defect and got a little thick on one corner. So he's going to knock off that corner right now. And so that's what we're going to do, run it through my homemade thickness sander. Depends on how it bends. I mean, if you can bend it at 80, you're fine at 80. But you know, a lot of that hardwood won't bend at all at 80.
Damn you wrong.
What is that?
71. 70.
You can get pretty dang accurate with that thing if you
71.
If you take it.
Got the pattern roughly sketched on here just so I can get a length. Cut these off to proper length. Don't need it that long. Still have to thickness sand it, which I'll do right after this.
Bends on the sides, which is a different wood than I've ever bent before, so every time you do something like that, it's always a little bit of a new experience. Once again, this is called leopard wood, and we've got the iron heated up to over 400 degrees, and we've marked where our first bend should be, so we're about to get started.
This would be the right-hand side, as you're looking at the top face.
You spray the...
Yeah, spray both.
The inside cook bed?
Both. Spray both sides.
Spray both sides?
Or at least get the end here, get it wet. I always keep the flat side down so I can always know that I'm keeping it flat. And then you gotta make sure you know which way you want to do it. I think what I do first, I mean you can do that, but I think what I do first, try this. I would, you know, as it's wet like this, is this the end?
This is the outside and this will go in.
This is the
end? Gonna be bent this way.
Okay, so.
That's the waste.
And so this is the way you bend it, right?
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
So what I do is I do this to let some of the fibers stretch a little bit, because that's the way they're going to get bent. They're going to get bent that direction. That this side will bend no problem. That side would like to break.
Tear, man.
So sometimes I do this just to soften it up a little bit and just kind of get it used to the idea of stretching. And I'll let you take over from there.
Continue doing this side or then start on the inside?
You can do some more. You can go ahead and do the inside like you were going to do. Right at the moment, it's only getting at the top. That's, you kind of almost have to pick it up to get it on there real good. And then just keep it flat as the... down. Soak it up again and then go ahead and try your other side and bend it. It looks like it's going to bend easy because it's already kind of got some of that memory in there. So you can go ahead and put your thing on there. You don't want to get it bending too far without keeping the backing on it. Trust me, they don't like to bend without breaking.
top is set overnight, glued and clamped. Good matching, best we could get it. Here it is after a light sanding. I think it's going to be beautiful. That's it, be the inside. This is the top wood I purchased from Old Standard here in Missouri. And I'm trying to figure out which is. All right, I'm thickness sanding one of the two tops. Take it down to about 100, maybe a little more than 100. And right now I'm at 168, roughly. So we're going to keep on rocking and rolling. Got to sand it down enough to get. Got one rough edge on it, which I don't see right at the moment. Oh, here it is. Right in here. So we should be able to sand it down enough to get that out. Because that's the center screw seam. This is going to be the sound hole. All right. Laying here, and has a little defect in it here. Once it's sanded down, it exposed this little knot internally, front and back, not so visible here. And I'm trying to determine which side I want to show. I would have preferred to have this down here, but that would put it right here in the middle of this guitar. And I don't really want that. If I turn it this way, it's not so visible and probably wouldn't notice it. I would prefer that these vanes go up this way instead of going down this way in the back. This shows up on sound hole. There won't be a sound hole here. This is the back of the guitar. So I put that out, then let the other side of it go in. Probably won't see it much. That's my plan. Line up the center lines, top and bottom. that split out, making that bend a crack. So I'm going to attempt to tail and the neck block. I've already got the glue on this side. Got to turn the camera on. Not the greatest lighting over here, sorry.